Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to teach you chapter 9, Settled Life and Urban Civilization. Settled life means staying at one place for longer period. Urban means cities or town, and civilization in a very simple word means developed society. So today we will learn what was the process of settled life and urban civilization and how it developed. Before I start this lecture, if you are new to my channel, then please subscribe and press the bell icon for notification. So let's begin it. The main points of this chapter are use of metals, pot made on the potter's wheel, trade and transport, rise of cities and script, social organization in the ancient cities. So first let's begin with use of metals. You can see some of the ancient gold objects which were found in burial grounds of Bulgaria. It is saying that a scholar named Christian Thompson introduced a method for classifying the prehistoric artifacts and antique objects. It is called the 3A system. Thompson classified the objects into three groups. Here, artifacts means what? Artifacts means the object which were made by human beings. So, Christian Thompson classified the objects into three groups, and it is known as 3A system. And they are stone tools. Stone age means the period in which stone tools were mainly used, known as stone age. Copper tools and other copper articles, copper age. The period when copper tools came into use is known as copper age. Iron tools and other iron articles, iron age. The period in which mainly iron tools and other iron articles were used is known as iron age. Thompson established with the help of evidence that stone tools were the earliest. Evidence means proofs, facts. So with the help of facts, evidence, he said that stone tools were the earliest. You may have wondered about the first metal that human used. Actually, gold was the first metal to be used. Gold is a soft metal, so it couldn't be used for making tools and implements. Why was man unable to use gold for making tools and implements? Because gold is a soft metal, therefore it couldn't be used for making tools and implements. Human then discovered another metal which could be used for these purpose, and that metal was copper, because copper is harder than gold. The period when copper came into use is known as copper age. Pots made on the potter's wheel. The copper age was the age of many new inventions and rapid changes. The invention of the wheel is the most important among them. During the copper age, there were many new inventions. Invention means discovery, okay? So, for example, the invention of wheel is the most important discovery or invention of copper age. These inventions brought rapid change in the society. It is generally agreed that the wheel was the first used by potters. Its use in carts and chariot probably began a little later. So it was potter who used a wheel for the first time. You can see in this picture that a potter is using wheel for making pots. After that, the wheel was used in cart and chariot for the transportation.
ट्रेड एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट, ट्रेड मीन्स बिजनेस एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट मीन्स टेकिंग और कैरिंग पीपल और गुड्स फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर बाय मीन्स ऑफ अ व्हीकल। सो लेट्स सी हाउ ट्रेड ग्रू एंड व्हिच व्हीकल वाज यूज्ड फॉर ट्रांसपोर्ट। हियर इट इज सेइंग दैट वंस द पॉटर बिगैन टू यूज अ व्हील, इट बिकेम पॉसिबल टू मेक पॉट्स इन लार्ज नंबर्स। People started making symmetrical, symmetrical means same shape and size, and colorful pots with beautiful design on them, as you can see in this picture. So, in the similar way, they started making beautiful design on the pot. Potters and other craftsmen began to live close to each other in the village settlement so as to manage their work more easily. Why did the potters and other craftsmen live close to each other in the village settlement? So that they can manage their work more easily. We can say that this became the industrial area of that village where skilled craftsmen had their settlements and center of production. So in this way, industrial area emerged where skilled craftsmen had their settlements. As the scale of production increased, trade too expanded with it. Therefore, there was a need to change the old system of transport. And it was in this period that wheel vehicle like carts and chariot were first brought into use. So, you know, wheel vehicle like carts and chariot were first brought into use for the transportation. So here I am ending this lecture. I hope that you find this lecture interactive and informative. If you like my video, then please subscribe and press the bell icon for the notification. Like and share with your friends. Thank you for watching and listening to me.